Check, check. Thank you so much for being here this evening. We really appreciate you attending this culminating spring concert. These students have worked so hard this year, and playing for you tonight is just going to be a joy for them and for us. Cell phones, we are making nice recordings this evening, so please be sure cell phones are silenced. I know the message said that. And as far as the video is concerned, there are no more DVDs. There will be a link so that you guys can get the video of this concert maybe in a week or two. So I'll be emailing that information out so that you have that information. This next piece will be performed by The Strings. This is a fugue originally composed by Vivaldi and then later arranged by Sebastian Bach. Bach was a huge fan of Vivaldi, and this piece now is an amalgamation of these two songs together, and it's a beautiful fugue, and it's kind of been their alma mater this year. They performed it so many times. I hope you enjoy. Is a you'll hear are the modern harmonies. It's a beautiful work by Barnum. It's called Adoramus Te, Christe.
Switching places. This next piece, Southwest Saga, Robert Sheldon, the composer of this piece, came to Gulliver, went to the academy, and came to the Brett, and worked with our ensembles for a full day. And he's been doing this now traditionally. He is a phenomenal person, phenomenal musician, and educator, and clinician. So we actually were honored by having the composer there to give us his, you know, perspective on his own piece. You can't argue with the composer. And this is a really fun piece. It has some Western flair to it. You'll hear a trumpet solo in there by Chris Ricardo. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Adrian helped publish this piece through his publishing company, Leave Your Music, and so thank you very much. We took this song to States, which was a first for us. Very proud of the strings. This is Furioso. Two of our own faculty joining us, Mr. Ryan Trout, Mr. Drew Carnelli. Would you please come to the stage? Have you seen this? I'd also like to give a shout out to Mrs. Taylor for playing piano on this episode. Just a little bit about this. I completely composed a very, very difficult version of this song back in 2000, and it was actually premiered here on this stage under the baton of Dr. Joe Michael Scheibe with the University of Miami's Chorale. I made it a little bit more accessible, but it's still a very difficult piece of music. You'll hear the words. I'll let you make your own interpretation of the words on this. But there are very few choruses that I could hand this piece of music to. And not to speak ill of any of our other choruses, because they've all been phenomenal. But this chorus right here is one of the best and that I've ever taught. And it's like... because they really, all the years, they've been phenomenal, and I love my alumni. But this is like the Chicago Bulls with Michael Jordan. This is like the Celtics with Larry Bird. This is like the New England Patriots with Tom Brady, right? Enjoy.
I had to get the Patriots in.
So you can hear the difficulty in that. Different time signatures, crazy lyrics. Lost my mind. This next piece by Carter, we did a 2-year span of Carter works. Last year we performed Symphonic Overture, maybe 2 years ago. This year is Overture for Winds by Carter. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
A New World Symphony by Dvorak, written in 1893. Very recognizable work. We are obviously not going to play the whole thing, and it's arranged for strings only, but you will hear many of the recognizable themes in the New World Symphony. Thank you. This next piece, sung by the choir, Daniel, servant of the Lord. This will feature two soloists, Alex Ortiz, alto. And Gonzalo Schaps. Before we play the last song of the first half, just want to let you guys know that there will be a 15 to 20 minute intermission outside. Thank you to Jennifer Kaufman and her crew of amazing parents for putting that together. In addition to the delicious food, we're trying to figure out ways to signify the end of intermission. It's always a challenge out there. So there will be two performances outside to signify the end of intermission. There will be a performance by our Bast vocal quartet and our women's trio. When you hear those two groups singing, after the trio, I think it is, that'll signify to come back upstairs. And you'll want to hear those two groups, trust me, they are beautiful. So this is Jurassic Park. Need I say more?
Thank you.
I hope that you were able to hear our two choirs outside. Please give them a round of applause if you would. Just a little history of what's been going on. So we've had the year of broken bones in the music program. Started off with Javi breaking both the bone bones. So Awal had to play lead tenor for him in MPA, so thank you Awal for doing that. And then our lead alto, Kyle, who was a ball boy for the Miami Open, I guess that's a dangerous job, broke his wrist. So, and then Zach, this week, one of our percussionists played snare, crash cymbal, timpani, broke his wrist. Our second alto player and soloist, he's in the jazz combo. He broke his pinky and his knuckle this week. So I'm going to fill in on second alto for him tonight. So I'm going to have you up. This is Bossa Rio, nice laid back bossa nova, so you can just sit back and chill. And this is going to feature Javi on tenor sax.
Thank you.
give us some nice laid-back swing here. This one is going to feature Kyle Bramson on alto sax.
Yeah.
awesome sounds. And thank you, by the way, for spending your Cinco de Mayo with us. We really appreciate it. Not that Boston has anything to do with Cinco de Mayo, it's actually a different country. Anyway, so Blue Sky for a Rainy Day is our next piece. This will again feature a nice solo by Kyle Bramson.
Take the A train.
piece, a beautiful ballad that most of you know, When I Fall in Love. We had, I think we had 11 people audition for this solo, and it was a really, really close call to the fact where we had to have a call back and re-audition the top two. I want to bring up the winner of that vocal audition, Sophia Gonzalez-Rebel. She is... this will also feature Kyle Bramson on alto, Matteo Graziosi on trombone. And this is Sophia. Hello, Chris. Okay, so just to take a breather for a second, I just want to say a couple of thank yous before we do the brief prep music award ceremony, and I appreciate you indulging us with that award ceremony. It's really important for these students to be recognized. First, I'd like to thank all the administration and the faculty for being here tonight. Thank you so much for supporting us. Silver for live streaming this. The University of Miami staff for recording this and doing all these mics. The UM staff is amazing, so thank you so much. Two special people I want to thank. I'd like to bring up my lovely assistant, Mrs. Taylor. But she's my right and left hand at work, helping you with paperwork and everyday, day-to-day operations. And we are yin and yang, we think exactly alike, we work great together, and I'm very appreciative. Jennifer Kaufman, if you are here, Jennifer Kaufman, could you come to the stage, please? Now, I've taught Allegra and now Angelique. She has done, this young lady, this young lady has done the intermissions for our holiday and spring concert. I won't even say how many years, but she is responsible for all the intermissions for our holiday and spring concerts. And 5 or 6, everyone is graduating and she's leaving us. So I want to thank her. Later. So we are going to just get to this award ceremony, and again, this is truly important for our students, and I know that there was an academic award ceremony, and there's lots of awards, but these ones are very special. As a matter of fact, before we even start, I'd like to, we haven't done this before, but I'd like to have the students that were recognized at the academic awards to come to the stage. So we did have these, we have 12 awards in all, 7 are given tonight, but there were 5 given last Wednesday, and I'd like them to come to the stage as I announce who they are. For Best Instrumentals and Strings, we had Luis Martinez. Give them their plaques and recognize them. Performing in the 2018 sight reading choir was Nate Rich. And performing in the 2018 concert choir, Gonzalo Schatz. He was basically given a full ride to UCF by our judge. And he's like, you're coming to UCF for free. So I mean, his voice is amazing. All right, so we're going to get on to these awards tonight. The John Phillips Youth of Band Award, we're going to start with this one. This award is given to a band member that demonstrates leadership, especially by setting an example of the highest standard of performance dedication to the music program. Tonight, and for the first time ever, we actually had a tie for this award, so we have two. We'll just say female and male. She is the band president, the flute and clarinet section leader, playing flute in both the wind ensemble and jazz ensemble. She received superior rating at both district and state solo ensemble festivals for flute. Her smile and energetic personality always light up a room, even when her enthusiasm for everything she does is truly contagious. It has been an honor to know her for these past 4 years. Her mom has also been an amazing asset to both the dance and music programs. And we cannot thank her enough. I guess the answer is all part of the tree, right? Heading to the one and only University of Miami, go Bats. The John Phillips Youth of Band Award 2018 goes to Nikki Hurtado. And now for the senior award we have for Reliable. This is the one word to describe this young man. He is always there, always knows his music. He is the epitome of the values of the prep music program. He is talented and humble. He is the trumpet section leader for both wind and jazz ensemble, and is a perfect role model for the high expectations of our music program. He earned a Maestro Award from World Strides National Music Festival back in April on our trip to Orlando. He also received the Best Instrumentalist of Band Award last Wednesday. On top of playing the trumpet, he is in AP Music Theory and sings tenor in the chorus. As he is only a junior, I am looking forward to working with him in his senior year. The second John Phillips Sousa Band Award goes to Chris for Clark. Especially by setting an example of the highest standard of performance and dedication to the music program. He is a versatile multi-instrumentalist and vocalist. Playing both baritone horn and bass trombone, is the vice president of the band, receives superior ratings at district, state, and solo ensemble festivals, and is also a perfect role model for the high expectations of our music program. Although he is receiving a band award, this talented young man has also taken AP Music Theory and is a prominent voice in our bass section and chorus. He will be heading to Sarah Lawrence College in Bronx, New York in the fall to major in music. The Patrick Gilmore Band Award 2018 goes to Tommy Hernandez. This award is given to a chorus member that demonstrates leadership and true dedication to chorus and choral literature. This young man has performed in Carnegie Hall twice and in the Sydney Opera House in Australia this past summer. He was also selected to and performed in the National Association for Music Education's All-National Chorus in Orlando earlier this year. This year he received the highest honor from the state of Florida for a vocalist as he was selected to the elite and exclusive Florida All-State Reading Choir. This includes only 150 of the top sight reading high school vocalists in the entire state. He is always prepared for his solo ensemble music, for which he receives superior ratings at both district and state festivals, as a soloist and as a member of a quartet. His beautiful tenor voice will be missed next year as he heads off to the University of Richmond. See how much it means to these students. The National Orchestra Award 2018. This award is given to a string ensemble member that demonstrates leadership and technical proficiency, especially by setting an example of the highest standard of performance and dedication to the music program. This young man, in addition to being our concert master, string ensemble president, chief executive officer of our music club, and winner of the Best Instrumentalist for Strings Award, is an eloquent speaker, leader, and representative for our music program. I often have to Google half the words he says, but it's okay. He frequently speaks and or performs in Parents Association's meeting about his participation in and love for the Prep Music Program. He has found a home here and has led his fellow musicians with dedication, love, and pride. He ran many sectionals this year and has always had the respect of his peers. He helped to lead the chamber strings and the string ensemble to superior ratings at both district and state festivals. It goes without saying that he will be missed next year. As he heads off to Vanderbilt University in Nashville, Tennessee, he'll forever have an empty space that can only be filled by his boisterous laugh, his eloquent rants, and his hilarious bickering in Spanish with his stand partner. Students like these are the reasons why teachers teach. The National Orchestra Award 2018 goes to Luis Martinez. This young man has surely demonstrated this all year long. His abilities on the drums and his immersion into jazz has clearly been evident. With his guidance and leadership, our jazz combo received superior marks at both district and state festivals. They were able to perform for 2 straight hours at the Prep Art Show on April 24th. I know he has lots of plans for next year's jazz ensemble and jazz combo. He's been in chorus and is getting serious about jazz guitar for next year as well. In our final song this evening, you'll hear him as we let him solo, let him out of his cage for a little while. As he's only a junior, I look forward to working with him in his senior year, and I anticipate a lot of great things from this young man. The Louis Armstrong Jazz Award 2018 goes to Jake Fine. Excels in wind or string ensemble, but also in jazz ensemble. Not only did he excel in jazz ensemble, he picked up a brand new instrument to do so. Because jazz viola really isn't much of an option for jazz, right? And he knew we needed bassists for our jazz ensemble, so he agreed to tackle a new instrument. With a lot of practice and the help of his private lesson teacher, he has come such a long way. He was even selected as the bassist for our jazz combo and has done a fantastic job laying down all kinds of different bass lines. In addition to bass and viola, he is also in chorus and AP Music Theory. The Woody Herman Band Award 2018 goes to our, and you all understand, underspoken, timid, quiet, filtered, and introverted violist, bass vocalist, and AP Music Theorist, John Howell.
oops, he missed us. And so we all wanted to express to see a little something before we leave. So you want to start off, Tom? Yes.
I like wrote a script for this and I forgot it all. It's just been so hard. They told me to be quick, so I say, but just you two have like changed my mind. And that's from the bottom of my heart. Because I know that I wouldn't be on the stage and I wouldn't be with these people. And I wouldn't have the experiences that I've had and I wouldn't have the opportunities that I've had. I don't know what else to say other than thank you. And I know all of us are going to say thank you to billion times. And to me, I don't think thank you is enough for that. But really, just thank you from the bottom of my heart.
I love you.
Your next 4 years that really inspired me, and you wrote my rec letter, and I'm going to Frost. I just want to thank you both, because there's really no words to appreciate everything you guys have done, so thank you so much.
For you guys that are not aware, my music program, Mr. C gives these famous prezzies. The first of the classes of our music endeavors. And one of those points he makes is it's not his goal for us to be professional musicians, but if it does happen, that's great. But his first main goal is to make us better people. And as I look up on the stage, these friends and those down there, you did exactly that. And I can't thank you enough for that, man. Thank you.
Mentors and joining
this year showed me that the most music you can get is the best way to live. So coming into the music room every day has just been amazing, because even if I'm upset at school or having a bad day, I can come in and someone I don't know will cheer me up. And my one regret is not joining music sooner. And I just wanted to say thank you for that.
Silence will always be charged with the music we make. I would have lost a family, and I would have lost everyone in my orchestra and everyone in the music program. So I have to thank you. You say I like speaking, I'm good with words, but this is the one thing I can't speak about. I can't. And I will never be able to.
Thank you.
2018 seniors. That's it. You know, I have to thank all of you for coming to these spring concerts and sitting there listening to the thank yous, the awards, the seniors. Unless you're in the music program, you can't comprehend the family atmosphere, the love that is felt between all of us. You can't make music like you heard on stage tonight, unless you care about every single person sitting next to you. And I feel like in this music program, we have that. And to graduate 24 ridiculously talented and amazing people is painful. To say the least. I miss all of them. Thank you, students. I love you. And I know that we want to close this out with some music and some uplifting spirits here. Again, congratulations, seniors, and thank you. Thank you to the music students. Thank you all for being here tonight and supporting the music program. We're going to finish it off with a nice funk chart called Solent. This will feature Kyle on alto, Christopher Carter on trumpet. I'm going to take a solo on alto for fun. And then Jake is going to solo on the drums, like I said. Thank you all so much for being here. This is so good. students. Have a great summer, everybody.